Hello, in this video we'll be going over how to create an external entity and how to give access to a Mongoose application with a specific form. This guide is intended for customers who often work with independent third-party entities where these entities need the ability to access Infor applications to fulfill their commitments. The customers would not want to manage these users within their active corporate directory, and instead they expect to be able to create and manage these users in a separate user store. One example would be that an Infor customer wants to use Mongoose to create portals accessible by external users. Before we begin, you do want a security role to be able to access the external entity management. You just need ifs-externalentityadmin or infor-systemadministrator. You do not need both, you just need one. And this will let you access the external entity management option in the Mingle user menu. So let's get started on creating an external entity. So you just want to go over here and click on External Entity Management, and it'll bring you to this page in Mingle. And we're going to go ahead and click Add. Create an external entity without a profile. For the code, we're just going to use Acme. This is kind of like a prefix for the external entity, and it'll appear before the users in your users table in Mongoose. Name and description, name it whatever you want. Same with the description. Organization name if you need it. Status active, max number of external users. You can set it here if you want. If you just want an infinite number of users, you can just leave it blank. And then external authorized components and applications. You want to go ahead and add. And we are going to add portal and self-management. Click add and close. And then we're going to go ahead and scroll up back up to the top and click save. And once it has saved, we can go ahead and now start creating the application. So to do that, we want to go to Mongoose first. And when you're in the screen, you want to do right click, view frame source, and grab the link at the top and put it in a text editor. So after you paste the link, you want to grab a few things from it. You want to grab the web server here. You want to grab the tenant, which should be a little bit down the line. There it is. And go ahead and paste that. You want to grab the config, which should just be this right here. And then the config group should be pretty early in the URL. So we're just going to grab that. Since we have grabbed those from the link, you want to go ahead and put it into this template, or it's https://, the Mongoose web server, then WS web client, session, open, configuration name. That's where you would substitute the config. Theme equals light, tenant, is where you put your tenant name, config group, is where you put your config group, force SSO equals 1, and S type equals full. So this is what my link looks like for my current environment. So we're going to go ahead and copy that and go back into Mongoose. And once we're back in Mongoose, we're going to go ahead and click on our Mingle user, go to admin settings, go to add application. We're going to do Infor non-provisioned. We're going to go do Mongoose 9.0. Display name, you can choose a display name. Do Mongoose Acme. You can choose the icon color if you want. Go with blue. And here's where you want to do your logical ID. And the host name is that link that we created using the web server, the config, the tenant, and the config group. And you can leave everything else the same. Go ahead and save. So once it saves, you should get this screen. And we're going to go over to custom parameters. And under form, I have a form prepared. And this is the form that will greet the external entity user when they log in to their external entity. This will be the form that pops up. And we're going to go ahead and click save. And once that has saved, we can go ahead and go back to external entity management. We're going to click the little hamburger up at the top and go down to custom authorized components. And we're going to click on the plus button to add one. I'm going to name it same as our application. Logical ID, you should see the logical ID that you set your application as. And we're going to go ahead and add two security roles. We're going to add portal user. Set the same as the description. And we're also going to add a Mongoose Acme user. And then we're going to go ahead and save. So now we're going to add our custom authorized component to our external entity. So we're going to go ahead and hover over and click on edit. And once we're back in, we're going to go down to external authorized components and applications, and we're going to add our Mongoose Acme application. Do an add and close and save. So now you want to double click on your external entity to bring up the users. And we're going to go ahead and add a user. I'm going to add myself. And this will send out an email to the user, allowing them to sign up. Just go ahead and save. And once it saves, we're going to go ahead and edit the user and give them security roles. We're going to go ahead and add security roles for portal. And then we're also going to add our two roles that we created for the application for the portal user and the Mongoose Acme user. So we're going to head and add these two. And then we're going to go ahead and add and close and save. And once the security roles have saved, we can go back into Mongoose. And we're going to go ahead and open up the users form. And we should see our Acme right at the top with our user that we created. So we're going to go to user modules. And we're going to add two user modules. We're going to add MG user created forms. And we're also going to add MG user created IDOs. So they have access to the forms and IDOs that you create. Go ahead and click save and then close to go back to the users form. And once we're back on the users form, we're going to go ahead and open up the groups form. And we're going to search for our external entity code with an asterisk for a filter in place so we can get our groups for our external entity. And we're going to go down to the portal suite user group and we're going to go ahead and add our user. And then we're also going to do it for the portal user and the two security groups that we created. And also under the Mongoose Acme user, under group authorizations, we wanted to do a object type form, and the object name will be Mongoose Acme, which is the name of the form that we want to open when the external entity user logs in so that this form greets them. And we're just going to give them all the privileges, but you can go ahead and edit them to your liking and based on your form. So we're just going to close out of that. Make sure you save, close out of groups, and you should be good to go. I have already verified and created my account on the external entity, so I'm going to go ahead and log into that now. So here we are in the external entity user. As you can see, I'm logged in as myself, and we only have access to Mongoose Acme. And we're going to go ahead and log in now. And we can see our Mongoose Acme form loaded up correctly when we logged in, because that was the form name that we specified in the parameter in the application to open up. And congratulations, you made an external entity that opens up into a Mongoose application that has a preset form in it. So this will conclude the tutorial video on how to create an external entity and give them access to a Mongoose application, which opens a specific form. Thank you.